Hello, Damien. Thank you
Hello.
for your presentation. Yes, I have a question. So you found or you assume that you could have a correlation between the Vespa velutina load, so the number of hornets predating at the colony entrance, and the foraging paralysis. This is, I think, it's the direct link. Is it's okay? And then I did not catch why you expect to have a correlation with the Varroa. What is the causal link? What's the hypothesis, the link between foraging paralysis and Varroa infestation? Basically, Varroa is the dynamic of the Varroa is based on the broods, so the presence of broods in the colony. And I have in mind that if the colony stop to forage, so stop to harvest or to there is no intake of pollen, so basically you should have no brood, so it could have a positive effect on Varroa control. So I would assume the reverse, that foraging paralysis, so the house and hornet, could have a positive effect on Varroa control, so less Varroa. But maybe I'm wrong.
No, no. Thank you very much for bringing that up. It actually makes a lot of sense. And we expect to have less group immunity due to the predation of Vespa velutina. And this we wanted to see if there was any effect in any of the most relevant parasites. We should not necessarily expect in the case of Varroa, more Varroa, the more attacked, because it's multifactorial. Like you can maybe have, yeah, it depends on the brood quality. And even though there's a foraging paralysis during the day, maybe some of the hives can have also nocturnal habits to clean the cleaning, nocturnal cleaning habits. So yeah, and even in some cases we have seen exactly this. Like the more attack in specific hives, we have seen this. Like there's no clear pattern that we can say that this occurs in 100% of the cases. And also this is still pretty preliminary. But yeah, we didn't want. We don't necessarily expect a high Varroa with the high attack. Yeah, that's true.
Ah, okay, thanks. Thanks a lot.
Yes, Peter, other question?
It's a follow-on question to Fabrice's one. I'm curious as to whether you have data on the honeybee colony dynamics that can potentially explain the mechanism by which Vespa velutina is affecting either Varroa or Nosema. The sort of type of data I'm imagining is so making assessments of levels of brood sort of at various intervals during the season. Estimates of numbers of bees within the colonies, all sort of things that can maybe help confirm the mechanism involved.
Yeah. There are many variables that were measured in these hives, but this is something that Sandra will talk about right after me.
Okay, thank
you. Like pollen, honey, brood quality, quantity, everything. So it's something that Sandra will talk about right now.
So thank you very much, Damian. We don't have time for more questions. Sorry. So thank you again, Damian. Thank you.